The mountainous task to speak about one of the pillars of the most distinguished and the most unique Sufi path, which is the Silsilat al-Zahabiyya, the Tariqa al-Naqshbandiyya al-Mujaddidiyya. And subhanAllah, it gives one goosebumps to realize that we have a connection to such a great man of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the moments that I have been given, inshallah, just a few points, that through this we will be able to do shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has given us such an azim nisbah. Then also for us to appreciate the worth of this nisbah. And then for us to see that, are we following as well with the Khwajagan? And to start, we mentioned that Sayyidi wa Mawlai Hazrat al-Khwaja Urwat al-Wuthqa radiallahu ta'ala, and he was sitting with his grandsons and he looked at all of them. And the first one he saw was Hazrat Abu al-A'la, who is the son of Hazrat al-Khwaja Hujjatullah al-Naqshband radiallahu ta'ala. And when he looked at him with the light of the maqam of the Qiyum, because Hazrat al-Urwat al-Wuthqa was the second Qiyum, and his son was Qiyum al-Thalith, and the one we're talking about is al-Qiyum al-Rabi'. And they looked at Hazrat Abu al-A'la, and they said that through him we see that he will have a son who will illuminate from east to west, north to south, and in him we will see the manifestations of our noble ancestor and our noble master, Imam Rabbani, Mujaddid Alif Thani, Sheikh Ahmad Al-Farooq As-Sarhindi radiallahu ta'ala. And he will be the one that who will complete and who will bring forward the ways of Imam Rabbani. And it so happened that when the life of the noble Khwaja was mentioned, that one day Hazrat Hujjatullah, he saw his son. And his son from the age of 12, so Hazrat Abu al-A'la from the age of 12 to his time, he would cover his face. And one day the noble Khwaja asked his son, Hazrat Abu al-A'la, why have you covered your face? That apne ye niqab, apne jo burqa poshi, why have you done this? As is written in Rawdat al-Qayyumiyya. And he said that the reason I have been covering my face is that at every moment I behold the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. I see him morning and evening. I see him before me, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And I have covered my face that I do not want my eyes to look upon anyone else apart from him, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Hence why I have covered my face. And then Hazrat Hujjatullah, they asked him something concerning the health, to ask the noble messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And then they were given the answer through their son. And it is mentioned that when Hazrat Hujjatullah al-Naqshband, that when he went for the Hajj and he presented himself in front of the Rawd al-Mutahara in Medina al-Munawwara, in the most luminous and the most fragrant and the noble court of the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And when he presented himself there, and he was given the glad tiding from Sayyid al-Awwaleen wal-Akhirin sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that you will be given a farzand, a son, and that who will have a unique connection, a nisbati khas, with the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And this was the glad tidings that was given to Hazrat Hujjatullah al-Naqshband. And to mention, alhamdulillah, one point in relation to the birth of Hazrat al-Qayyum al-Rabi', Hazrat al-Khwaja Muhammad al-Zubayr Shamsuddin al-Sarhindi radiallahu ta'ala, and that some of the biographers, they write that when he was born, there's many miraculous and amazing things were behold. One of them was that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that he said that the akhir qiyum of my ummah has been born, and that he will be the one that who will revive my way, and that that after him there will be no one that who will occupy the seat of the qiyum. Because this is a maqam which we don't have time to mention, but it was one of the openings given to Imam Rabbani. So our chain of transmission, do hamari mashayikh, and we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this without boast, bila fakhr. Our mashayikh, they include all of the qayyums of the silsila. So the next Bandi transmission, one will have from Imam Rabbani, they go off, or from Imam Urwatul Wuthqa, they go off. But our silsila, our mashayikh, they come through. Hadith Hujatullah Naqshband, Hazrat Khwaja Shamsuddin Muhammad Zubair radiallahu ta'ala, and through and to our Shaykh Sultan al-Awliya Hazrat Khwaja Subi Muhammad Asim rahmatullahi alayhi wa radi, and our present Shaykh Hazrat Khwaja Riyad Ahmed. And they mentioned that his kunniya, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mentioned that it will be Abu al-Barakat, and his laqab, his title will be Shamsuddin, and his name will be Muhammad Zubair. So this was gift given to the noble master, our Khwaja, the coolness of our eyes, Al-Qayyum al-Rabi, from the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And a beautiful event which occurred. And inshallah, we will mention this, and then one or two points about the Ma'mulat, and then we will conclude because of the time. Just to give us a flavor and appreciation of this noble man. Hazrat Hujatullah al-Naqshbandi radiallahu ta'ala, and there was a gathering that was held. And in this gathering, he called all of the halqa, all of the khulafa and the murideen. They were present in the noble luminous court of our master, Hazrat Hujatullah al-Naqshbandi. And in this gathering, which took place, and it is mentioned that after that a full 100 years after the Hijri calendar, that I have given the seat of the Qutb, I have given the seat of Al-Qayyumiyya to Hazrat Al-Khwaja Muhammad Zubair radiallahu ta'ala an, and that he is the one that who will now carry this nisbah and this silsila forward. And then Hazrat Hujjatullah Naqshband, he commanded all of the halqa and his khulafa, and they all done bay'ah upon the hand in the presence of Hazrat Hujjatullah. They done bay'ah and they renewed their connection with the silsila in the presence of Hazrat Hujjatullah Naqshband on the hand of Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair. And then Khwaja Muhammad Zubair, Hazrat Khwaja Hujjatullah Naqshband, subhanallah, kaisa manzar hoga. They said to Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair, they said, aap tawajjuh farmaye in par, that you give them your luminous gaze upon the people sitting before you. And these were those that who served his grandfather. These were those that who had served his father, Hazrat Khwaja Abu al-A'la. And now they were sitting in the suhba, in the company of Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair. And Hazrat Hujjatullah Naqshband, they said that now your tarbiyah, your teachings, it will be through this noble son of ours, Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair radiallahu ta'ala. Again, time doesn't permit for us to go into any further detail. And just to mention one or two points about, and then when they were given the khilafah, and they were made the khalifa, and the amana which the Shaykh had when he was given from them to Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair radiallahu ta'ala, and Hazrat Khwaja Hujjatullah Naqshband, they were very happy. They were very pleased that I have fulfilled my duty, and the covenant that was given to me, the responsibility given to me by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I fulfilled this. And many of the murideen and the khulafa, they write that janab ka mamool kya tha, shab-e roz unka kaisa tha. That they say that unka jo shab-e roz tha, it was ba'in in the in the mirror image of the shab-e roz of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That each action of Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubair was a mirror image of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That meaning that when he would wake up in the morning to when he would retire for bed at night, that his whole day was following and was in accordance to the mannerisms and the way he sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam spent his day. And to mention one point, unka jo wuzu karne ka jo tarika tha, and that when they would make wudu, one of the du'as that they would recite will be al islamu haqqun wal kufru batil. They will recite this, then they will commence their wudu, and also that each adha they will recite it three times, they would wash it three times, and they will recite certain adhkar as they are making their wudu. And once that they would finish their wudu, they would look at the sky and they would recite some of the du'as, and one of them they would recite, as Imam al-Ghazali has mentioned in his Ihya Ulumuddin, that they would look in the sky and they would recite, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abdu wa rasuluh subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika la ilaha illa ant amiltu summa zalamtu nafsi astaghfiruk allahumma wa atubu ilayka faghfir li wa tub alayya innaka antat tawwabur rahim allahumma ij'alni min at-tawwabin waj'alni min al-mutatahhirin waj'alni min al-ibadik min ibadik as-salihin waj'alni 'abdan saburan shakura waj'alni adhkuruka katiran wa sabbihuka bukratan wa asila. They will make this dua, and as Imam al-Ghazali has written, that a person who makes his dua, after he has made his wudu, looking at the sky, that all his sins will be forgiven. Allahu Akbar. So this was some of the ma'mool. And also Hazrat Khadim Muhammad Zubair, that he will also, between the sunnah and fard namaz, they will recite, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. And now look at what a beautiful gift we were given by Hazrat Khadim Hafiz Abdul Karim, rahmatullah alayhi, that we were given it from the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as is written in Hidayatul Insan ila fi sabil al-irfan, that the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave them, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-azim, astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbin faghfir li. So Hazrat Khadim Muhammad Zubair, they would do talqin to all of their muridin to recite this, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-azim, to recite this and make at least 100 times zikr of this a day. And unka jo mamool, that after the fard salat, they would recite, Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam tabarak ta rabbana ya dhal jalal wal ikram. This was some of the mamool. And just to finish, that one of the mamool of the mashayikh, and subhanallah, this is, we see that it is one of the orders of the silsila, and that is that in 7 days, Hazrat Khadim Muhammad Zubair radiallahu ta'ala, they would do one khatam of the Quran. And they would do the, as we do, Hamkatin, seven manzils of the Quran. So they would, and this was also the ma'mool of Hazrat Khadim Urwatul Wuthqa radiallahu ta'ala and as well, that they would start one day and they would finish on Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, and then from Surah Al-An'am to Surah At-Tawbah, and then from Surah Ibrahim, and then from Surah Anbiya, and then Surah Al-Qasas, and then Surah Safat, and then from Surah Muhammad all the way to Surah Mulk. And then they would do the khatam of the Quran, and that when they would do the khatam of Quran, they would make a very unique dua, and like this. And just to finish, jo unka jo mamulta, in terms of the eating of the, and the manner in which Hazrat Qadir Muhammad Zubayr radiallahu ta'ala, and that when they would sit, and they would sit with the family, and firstly, they would ask each and every one, how was your day? What did you do today? Any murid who came to visit them, they would sit with them. They would present them food. They would eat with them. And they would inquire how their day was. What had they been doing? And then they would give them time. Each and everyone who came, this is how they entertained them. And personally for themselves, they were very, very sagacious in their way. That bilkul sadiqi se unka jo lafaz tha, imama sharif jab bhi wo pehante the, it was very, very simple. And subhanallah, just to finish, many of the murid, they say that when we saw and when we observed our murshid, the coolness of our eyes, al-qayyum al-rabi, Hazrat al-Khwaja, Khwajagan, Sultan al-Awliya, Khalifatullah, Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Zubayr radiallahu ta'ala an, Abu al-Barqat Shamsuddin, that when he would be performing salat, in the prayer, they would see that we will see that his noble face will become so illumined and so luminous that you could not, it was like as if the sun is gleaming on the earth. And when they would make their ruku and the sujood, this is how was the nature of the prayer. And they said that it was like as if Hazrat Qada Muhammad Zubair radiyallahu ta'ala an was in the khudur, in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to read about these and mashallah to love them, to follow them, and also to do shukr that Ya Rabb al-Alameen, you have given us a nisbah with such people that when we read about them, our eyes weep. That subhanallah, hum kamzor log, gunagar, siyakar log, that we are people who are of no value, that we have a connection with these people. As Hazrat al-Khadir by Yazid al-Bistami, and we'll finish on this, he said that you should love the awliya, love them and venerate them. And love entails also to follow them as well. Not just ishka, no, follow. And Hazrat Khadir Bayezid, he said, one of the wisdoms of this is that if you love the awliya, the men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then your name will be present in their heart. And when the divine manifestation manifests itself on the earth and upon the hearts of the awliya, the names which are within the hearts of the awliya, those people are also blessed and they are forgiven and their wishes are given to them and all of this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us as it father with the Razak Sahib and all the brothers that have made this mahfil possible and who have given us this opportunity to mention a few words. Maybe if we had a full series in 2-3 hours or like a special sort of program in which you could mention some of the manakibs. And one of the khasais that mentioned about Hazrat Qadi Muhammad Zubair was that he inherited many things from the prophets alayhi wasalam, and he inherited from Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, he inherited from Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam as well. So this is one of the great men that we are connected with him.